this brother right here, Larry, he needs to go into the Hall of Fame for helping black actors. I'm talking about the good brother that we know as Denzel Washington. Look at this right here. Denzel and Pauletta gave a once struggling Amari Hart a place to stay and paid to keep his career from being, his car from being repossessed. Now, Larry, this is the same brother that helped out Chadwick Boseman get into acting school in Europe, and no one ever knew about it till he died. He's helped Amari Hart with, I've also heard about the things he did with Samuel L. Jackson, not necessarily help him get into acting, but to help him get bigger roles. I've also heard about some of the good things he's done for some other black people. At what point in time do we need to go ahead and just come on out and give Denzel the trophy that says, I am the number one my brother's keeper?
Yeah, man. I mean, that's fantastic. I mean, I love hearing about stuff like this because you don't hear it from Denzel.
Nope.
You know? That is what I love to hear. It's like he's doing these things and people are talking about them years later. Like Amari Hardwick talks about it years later after he's successful. And he's like, yeah, man, I was broke. I was about to be out the game because my car was about to get repossessed. I don't need a place to live. And they took me in. That's just fantastic. And, mm-hmm. you know, but I have to be honest with you. I don't know if I'm putting that little dude in my house. I got a wife.
Well, Larry, I'm gonna give you the Oprah answer. If you secure in your relationship, it shouldn't matter. You know, if you secure in your relationship,
I'm not sure I'm secure enough to have that pretty Negro around.
Oh my lord!
I might just have to get him a hotel room.
Man, whatever, whatever. And you know, ladies and gentlemen,
in all seriousness, I think that's dope. I think that's dope. I love hearing stories like that. And you hear them every now and then. You hear about stories like Denzel doing that. You hear stories about Shaq that just like straight up buys entire apartment buildings and just tells people you're living rent free for a while till you get on your feet. And yeah. I mean, you hear about people doing all kinds of stuff that's just, you know, that's just really kind of cool. So
He deserves an award.
You hear people do stuff like during the like when back to school time would come around, you used to hear all these stories about, you know, about actors and singers and other people and, you know, black business folk that would just like pay for people's school clothes, you know, mm-hmm. and people, you know, some people think like, oh, it's a luxury to get school clothes, but it's not really, because if you're a kid and you're growing like a weed and you were 9 the year before and you've been growing all summer, and now you're 2 inches taller and 10 pounds heavier, your clothes aren't going to fit. You know, you need new clothes. And so if you don't have money to buy them, I think it's great when you hear about these stories about people doing things, you know, both small and large. So not as attention seeking either, not out there, you know, talking about it. Not people like you hear what's his name? Bill Maher always talks about, I did this for you. I had you on my show and this and that and blah, blah, blah. Jay-Z even called him out on it because he was taking all kinds of credit for stuff Jay-Z did. And Jay-Z was like, well, damn, you just want to take credit for my whole career, don't you? And sort of shut him up. But I like it when people don't need all the accolades. They just do what they do. And, you know, the joy they get out of it is seeing the people that they help succeed.
Right. And you know, that's one of the things I try to do with YouTubers and people doing their stocks and people doing their real estate. You know, I think to some degree, you've got to be someone where in your heart, you feel comfortable with where you're at. And you're not doing this because you feel a debt to society. You're doing it because you genuinely want to see other people succeed. You want to network with these people. Because you're building a community when you help people progress. You know, right. Teach a man to fish. Don't just give him the fish. And you'll have a friend for life. You know, you'll be able to talk about these things that you're going through. You're building a community when you help someone better themselves. And,
right.
But we've got a world of so many people, ladies and gentlemen, who they might tell you they want to see you succeed, but they really don't. They tell you that to your face. And when you got to put the ass on the grass, that grass is going to be very brown, if you know what I'm saying. So shouts out to Denzel, man. Shouts out to Denzel.
Yeah, and there are a number of folks out there that do that. And I mean, Shaq talked about how he was broke after his Miami Heat contract, after he won that championship. He was pretty much broke. And he said that when he went out there, I guess, to go talk with with Orlando.
Right.
He said he was pretty much broke. And then when he was going out to LA and he met with Magic Johnson, and Magic Johnson was like, you need to get your financial life together. And he was like, you need to stop buying crap and start owning stuff.
Exactly.
And he credits Magic Johnson with basically saving his financial life. He was like, it was because of him and his mentorship that he has the stuff that he has today. Cause he was like, he was blowing through money like there was no tomorrow.
I mean, when you come from nothing, cause I've been there too, Larry, when you come from nothing and they don't teach you this stuff in school about money, investing. They don't teach you that shit in school. They just don't, and they should.
Right.
But I'm coming from the hood. I moved up here to the Greensboro area for the first time making six figures. You know, I'm just walking around just because I can with like $2,000-$3,000 in my pocket, you know, just because. Like, and buying Air Jordans, and y'all know how I bash buying Air Jordans now. Buying the newest cell phone. I had the newest Volvo. I mean, just doing stuff that, how is that going to help me 10 years down the road? And thankfully, I started listening to a consumer advocate named Clark Howard that at the very least taught me you need to be saving XYZ because in 10 years it grows. And I kept listening. Then I started learning how to invest in the stock market. Then I got turned on to real estate. And then I got on cruise control because after a solid, hardcore 5 years getting my butt kicked, learning how to invest in all these things, your returns come back to you. And, you know, I can't say enough about that, man. And we need more people doing that part too, Larry, which is why me and Larry continue to bring you guys financial videos.